I thought you'd left for the day.
No, I was in the shower.
Oh, sorry.
Hey, no need to apologize.
You're doing your job, aren't you?
Yes, thank you for understanding, but please, don't report me to my boss. I might lose my job. I think I'll just come back and do this later.
No. You don't have to leave.
Please. I have some work to do in the back, so I have to go.
You like what you're saying, don't you?
The tribunal request form clearly states that we as a plaintiffs must show how this quarry project directly affects us as a community.
Well, let's see what we have. There'll be noise from the gravel machines, excessive dust which will affect the children's health, loss of forest which is bad for the environment, damage to our water supply, and the use of explosives will cause severe structural damage to many buildings, putting lives at risk. Matata is just exploiting the forest for his own good while blinding everyone with all that employment talk.
Actually, I was just expecting for half the performance your son has put up.
What chance do you think we have of this document going through and the tribunal actually being held here in Makutano?
Well, we have a good chance, but we have to act fast. Matata's an all-guard politician, and he may try to stop us. We really need to be very clever. Kafu's spraying insecticide.
Thank you.
He's gone on.
No.
Look,
Mr. Washington, don't you have a class to teach?
Ah, that's the time. Time really flies when you have such an expensive watch. Oh, sorry. Okay.
Good day, ladies. Let me go teach my little angels.
Is there something wrong with Mr. Washington?
I don't think so.
If anybody hears about this, not only will you be a dead woman, but your daughter will go through the same nice game before I slit her throat. Have you gone deaf? I'm talking to you. Did you hear what I said?
Yes, please. Don't hurt my daughter, please. Oh, please.
She's right. She won't get hurt.
Now get up.
I hope you have good reason for trespassing. This is private land. I could have you shot.
I'm sure that would give you great pleasure.
You can do this.
I want the whole area cleared.
Yes, sir.
Matata, what do you think you're doing?
I'm making unemployment an extinct phenomenon in Makutano.
Extinct? This is a disaster in the making.
You're creating a serious hazard on our children's lives. Look at what nearly happened to us.
The two of you are evidently careless. It is my land, and whatever happens to it when it happens is all in my hands.
But were you not supposed to start this in 3 months' time?
Ladies, on this piece of land, I am God.
That Mulani thinks just because he gave himself up, but will forgive him. If I was the chief, I'd lock him up in that cell forever. But imagine, I hear he said it was all an accident. How? Doctor, I'm sorry for selling, but people here like my Uchi. And besides, I need some money for me, Josiah, and the children.
Oh, please, somebody help me. Somebody help me.
So what improvements are you planning for this place?
Well, if you ask me,
I didn't. You just get on with your washing. Well, improvements are more of Mrs. Mabuki's line, as is just to do here.
And you do it very well.
Excuse me, mister, don't you think the Baba's is a more ideal place for you to hang out? Kwani, what do we have that they don't?
Beauty. This Mabuki, when he speaks to people, what does he promise them? I'm sure when you're working on your customers, you talk about stuff.
Oh, you mean gossip? Tony?
Yeah, our customers are women, and we talk a lot. Some say Mabuki has been a good counselor and he'll win. But he demolished the market stalls, and I think he's lost a lot of votes.
Mabuki said he had nothing to do with it.
Of course he would, wouldn't he? No one wants to admit making a mistake, especially right before an election year.
You're not scared of Mr. Mabuki, are you?
Of course not.
Well, you should be scared of Obaraka. She has all the women voting for her, and she's done a lot for Makutano. What have you ever done for us? Tony.
No, it's okay. The people of Makutano have not yet seen what I can do for them. But very soon, they will.
Yes, because you, my dear, are going to be MP of Makutano, and I'll be the MP's wife.
Okay, excuse me. Yeah, come on, let's go. Let's go and get some fresh air.
Hey, Fifi.
Hey, here's your milk.
And where's my Speedy?
He's busy on the farm. I'm not doing deliveries today.
Yeah. After how his date went with Tony, I don't think we'll see him around here for a while. I'll be right back.
All right. I've been following your campaign very closely. I like your opinions on the voice of the youth being amplified and their views being taken into consideration. That's great.
Thank you, young man. It is my dream to see a new country, and I plan to begin right here in Makutano.
You have good vision, yes. But I honestly think bringing in milk processing factories is a wrong move.
No, but that will increase production and create employment.
They kill small business. Mr. Kante, the people of Makutano believe in self-sustenance. People want to earn a living on their own and not rely on employment. Look around this town. Most of the shops are personal businesses, and they're doing really well. This is the pride we have in Makutano. Don't kill it.
Well, I must say that I never looked at things from that perspective. The people of Makutano are a really special kind of people, and I stand firm from the school of thought that a good leader must always listen to his people. Therefore, PP, was that the name?
Well, Philip, actually.
Right, Philip. I will let go of my milk processing plans and come up with something much more fitting for Makutano. I must thank you very much because the youth of Makutano will enjoy the biggest and sweetest fruits when I become the MP. Thank you.
No, thank you for treating me like an adult and listening to what I have to say.
Very right.
Here you are.
Thanks.
I got your vote, though.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
You're not really going to cancel your milk processing plans, are you?
Of course not. You have to tell some of these people what they want to hear.
Oh, you're so smart.
And all this happened at the lodge on top of the bar?
Yes. He threatened to kill me. I couldn't scream. Oh, God, I'm so scared. What if he has given me something bad? Oh, God, why me?
Calm down. I need to ask you some questions. Was there a struggle?
Yes.
Then I need to take some specimen from your nails. You haven't washed them, have you?
Could I have a bath first? I feel so filthy.
No, I'm afraid I cannot let you shower or change your clothes.
I can feel him all over me. He sent. Oh, God, please, he has to leave me alone.
Okay. But then I need to fold your clothes neatly in order to preserve any hair specimen you may have left behind.
Okay. And a shower, please.
Look, if you want to charge this man in a court of law, then you need to preserve all the evidence you've got against him. I'm afraid I cannot let you shower just yet. I also need to talk to you about the fact that the rapist may have been HIV positive. And in order to prevent you from contracting HIV, I'll have to put you on a 28-day course of ARVs. But you must go for a blood test first. And also need to give you a contraceptive pill, just in case of unwanted pregnancy.
Oh, gosh.
Shh, it's okay. It's okay. Calm down. You've been very brave to come in and telling me all this. Any rape victim must report the rape within 72 hours and seek treatment in case of HIV and unwanted pregnancy. Rest.
Oh.
Mr. Matano is coming to see you.
Oh, he has to catch that animal. He also threatened my daughter. Oh, God. Mama. Is it true what Ella says?
What did that loud mouth tell you?
Is it true that that man hurt you? Oh, I'm so sorry.
This development is coming to Makutano, and there's nothing you can do about it. Now, please leave before I call the police.
We can't let this happen. Hope, please tell me we can find someone to help.
Yeah.
Yes?
Matano, I urgently need your help. I'm down at the quarry, and there...
Madam Hope, I'm sorry. I'm handling something of very high importance. I cannot be of any help right now. Please, it will have to wait.
Yes, but...
Madam, I am sorry. Please, let us talk later.
We'll have to find some other way.
I'm happy to see you back in school. Me too. Although everybody's been talking about Dad, you know, whispering behind my back that he's a murderer and stuff.
It was an accident.
Yeah, I know. I just wish he never left. Maybe...
What?
Nothing.
You know, soon he'll have his hearing. And everybody will know that he was innocent.
Yeah. Thanks, Red, for taking care of us.
I hate you! I hate you! How could you keep quiet? I hate you! You kept quiet, and now that man has hurt my mother.
What man?
This morning, my mother was raped, and it's all her fault.
What? How?
Fellow had already disappeared. But my boys are out there hunting for him. He can't get far.
Promise me you'll find him and lock him in prison.
Try and get some sleep.
But what sort of fellow does such a thing?
I have no idea. But rape is more common than you think.
Maybe if women reported it more often, we would be able to stop such things from happening.
You know, in most cases, rape is often committed by someone the child or the woman knows. A husband or maybe a father. Most people are scared of speaking out because if they do, people don't believe them or they say that the woman deserved it. But this is the only way of stopping it, speaking out. Mama Pima has been very brave.
I don't know what I'll do if such a thing happened to my Margaret.
Stella. That man said, if I tell anyone, he's going to find my Stella. Please, go find him, please. Oh, my Stella.
Come on, we need to work faster. And this is our first order for Mr. Shah. We don't want to be late.
What does he have that I don't?
Mr. Shah.
That man was given initials for a name.
You mean KK?
Don't mention that name here. I can't believe that small Shannon would rather go out with somebody who has initials instead of going out with somebody who has a proper name like Speedy.
Hey, what's wrong with having initials for a name? And besides, I spoke to him earlier and I liked what he had to say.
Is this you? Pipi, that man is bad. How could you?
Ma Speedy, he has great plans for the people of Makutano and more so the youth.
Nothing he says will change what I feel about him. He's a thief. He stole my girl and wants to kill our milk bar. I'm voting for Hope. You should too. She is your sister.
Ma Speedy, you should learn that in true democracy, it's not who that matters. It's what they stand for. Hope isn't interested in development. Hope just wants things to stay the way they are.
I never thought I'd call you this, but you're a black sheep.
Call me whatever you want, but I will vote for the person who has the best ideas, who is honest, and who wants to turn Makutano into a better place. That's my stand. And if you're so hurt about small Sharon, why don't you go and tell her yourself?
Fine.
I meant after we're finished.
So you are here at the time. Did you see anything?
Are you sure this is one of your funny stories?
Hey, see, I was at the health center when she came in.
Because I bring that money.
I cannot believe it. Here in Makutano, it is becoming too much. Me, until somebody tries that kind of thing on me, I cut off his thing.
Kwanza, until he got away. How?
I don't know, but anyone who is raped will report it, whether you know the rapist or not. Otherwise, these people will never be caught, and they remain a danger to others.
That is true. That is true, Margaret. Now, here is your chair.
Hey, but Swali, can people see that this rape thing is bad? Just the other day, a woman was raped down at the river, and everybody knows it was her brother-in-law. Nothing happened, except she was beaten.
Now this woman cannot even leave the house because she's too scared.
Mm. Mm-hmm. Yes, but what was Mama Pima thinking working at the lodging? She knows the dangers of such a place.
What are you saying? Anna, you should be ashamed of yourself. It is not her fault.
I'm not blaming anyone. All I'm saying is that she was a bit careless, and those are the consequences.
Careless? For doing her job? Anna, when someone forces themselves on you, there is no excuse. It is not how you behave, where you work, or how you dress.
That is true. And rape is rape. It is illegal, but to meshoka.
No. You women are doing a very, very, very bad thing. And that is why women rape victims never come to report to the authorities. Because they know people like you are going to be talking about them just like you are doing.
Hey, Mr. Madano. We were not talking about Mama Bima being raped. We were just saying that she...
You're even making the situation worse for her and for all the other rape victims out there. We need to be sensitive. Instead of gossiping, we should be helping. Now, did any one of you see a man leaving the lodge earlier this morning? He must have been carrying bags and was probably in a hurry.
But just wait a minute. I think I saw the blue taxi parked outside my bookies. He must have been in it.
Ah, you see, Mama Mboga? Thank you very much. Now you're being helpful. And let us keep this between ourselves. Okay?
Mr. Otan, I need to talk to you.
This is not the time.
It's Kara and it's urgent.
How is she? Still in shock. Thanks for filling in for her at short notice.
Dad, are you okay?
I can't believe it. Here in my lodge?
Don't beat yourself up. You're not to blame.
My employee got hurt. How can I feel not responsible?
Yeah. I hear a woman was raped in your lodge today.
Matata, please. I'm not in a mood to bandy words.
Crime is on the increase in Makutano, and the worst of it is happening under your own roof, Mr. Mabuki. People may start talking, you know. Oh, the poor woman. I hope she recovers. Or maybe I should pay her a visit. I could win myself a vote or two.
Don't you dare try and use that poor woman suffering for your political advantage.
Or what?
Oh, you'll have to deal with me.
Well, I'm sure she'll vote for me anyway. Crime and personal security has just gone on top of my agenda. A round for everyone, Mabuki Junior. Ah, Kante. I can see you're getting to know your voters quite intimately. If I were you, young lady, I would hang out with the winning team.
Thanks, but I'm on the winning team. I tried to leave, but he hit me. I must have blacked out, because when I woke up, we were in the forest. He was on top of me, and I tried to pull him away, but he was too strong. After he had finished, he told me to go home and never tell anyone about it. He said he'd watch over me, and if I told anyone, he'd hurt me again. You have to understand, I couldn't tell anyone because I thought it was my entire fault. I was the one who wrote the stupid messages anyway.
It was my fault too, Kara.
Hey, I do not want to hear us blaming ourselves. I am very sorry for whatever happened. But what I want you to know is that it was not your fault, okay? The description of this fellow that you have given me matches exactly what Stella's mother told me.
Are you going to catch him?
Stella, give Mr. Matano some time to think.
So these emails, can I see them?
It's very beautiful.
Now, about loving me, do you honestly feel that way?
Yes.
Prove it.
How?
How dare you? You idiot! I thought you were a gentleman, but I was obviously wrong. Matata was right. You're a loser. Goodbye.
Mama, I'm sorry for running away. I was angry.
Angry? Who are you angry at?
Me. Mama Pima, the same man also raped me and I did not speak out. Not because of my stupidity, you also.
You knew about this too?
Yes, Mama.
You should have said something. You should always ask for help. The pain is too much.
Mama, it hurts.
Not this pain. In here. And I don't blame you guys. I love you both a lot, okay? I'm so sorry for what happened to you, Kara. We'll help each other to get through this, okay?
Thanks, Mama Pima.
I just hope Makutano finds him so that he'll never do this to anyone else.
Hey, Mr. Makutano. Why are you surfing such a website?
I am doing some investigation. So you also know about these things?
Yeah, I do, but I don't use it at all.
Good. Because it's not good to get used to such things. What kind of fellow would send such messages to anyone?
You know, Mr. Makutano, these guys always use fake names. But the thing they forget is that emails always state where they're sent from. So it's not as secret as they would want it to be. I guess I'll leave you the investigations. I have to get back to school.
Have you... Wow! She nearly made me all wet.
With the smell of you, you could use a wash.
I'm here to talk to that initials man. I have a few things that I need to tell that KK, and I won't leave here until I do.
Hey, I always like hearing what other people have to say.
Well, you see,
What the hell is that smell? Huh?
We, the people of Makutano, shall not be cowed into voting for you. We believe in ourselves, and we don't need your factories. Touch anyone's business in this town, and you will see fire. And stop brainwashing my small Sharon, because you're not worth her.
You're right. She dumped me.
Umeme!
You rock, dog!
With my project, the people of Makutano will be too busy to be involved in such crimes. Mm. It will be a lifesaver and an income earner.
Mr. Matata, you're a great man!
Mr. Harrison Matata?
Yes. Who wants to know?
I've just been served.
What do you mean?
We found something bigger than you.
The law. And that's an injunction stopping you from carrying on with your quarry project until a tribunal sits and makes a ruling.
But you can't do this.
Well, we did. And if you continue to build, you'll be breaking the law and risking your political career.
But...
We'll see you in court.
But...
And from now on, I have decided that you're no longer welcome in my bar. Have a good day.
Who's going to buy us free drinks now?
Just as I promised, this is my last drink.
Okay. I should be getting back.
I'll walk you.
You don't have to walk me home. I don't live far from here.
I insist. Lots of dangerous people out here, and a pretty girl like you shouldn't be out on her own, you know? Just let you go. Very good.
Bobby, or whatever your name is, you are under arrest for the raping of Kara Mulani and Mama Pima.